So during this session, we're going to take a look at perhaps one of my favorite features that Microsoft introduced inside of Excel 2013. This feature is called FlashFill. And here's what it fixes. Taking a look at my screen here, I've got three columns worth of data. I've got a customer name column there in column A. I've got column B for first name and column C for last name. Now, this is pretty typical. You get a list where a single column contains multiple pieces of information, such as first and last name inside of one column, rather than broken up into two separate columns. The problem is, when it's contained in one column, I can't really work with the two values independently of one another. For example, if I want to sort my list by last name, I can't really do that efficiently here because first name is also combined with last name. So I need to break it up into two separate columns so I can work with those values independently of one another. In the past, there was multiple ways to accomplish this. I could create calculations using like the left, right, and mid functions. I could use text to columns. I could retype it by hand. I didn't really want to do that though. So now Microsoft has introduced this tool called FlashFill. And this is how it works. So I'm going to jump over to the B column. And I'm going to start to type in the first person's first name, which is Patrick. So I'll type in Patrick here. Let's make sure I spell that right. I'm going to hit my enter key, and now I'm going to bring in Brent. But watch what happens as soon as I start typing in Brent. Excel's analyzing my data here, and it recognizes a pattern. It's picking up the rest of the first names, and all I have to do now is hit my enter key, and I'm done. Let's try it one last time. I'm gonna hop over to the last name. I'll type in Marlo. Once again, spell that right. Hit my enter key, here comes Burns. Oh, and it fills out the rest for me. A super slick feature. Does the work for you. It's now automated the data entry portion of filling out the first and last name columns based on the customer name column. Now what it's really looking for here is a consistent value to help us separate the two values. In this case, there's a space between each of the first and last names. Excel recognizes that, and that's how it's parsing or breaking the data up into the two separate columns for me. Try it out. I've provided this exercise file that's a part of this course. Jump into the third lecture, I believe it is, and try out this little exercise here.